Polita hit Vimes. You can see Brendan Roberts, number 26, and that was Polita just touching the grass, and the bike just wouldn't stop. It kept on going, bounced across him. Somehow, he avoided serious injury, and even the next bike that was collected here, Dionisi hits him hard and goes right over the top. And yet, phenomenally, Sheridan Marais also got involved in the flame and the mayhem, and incredibly, Polita scrambling to his feet there, probably unable to believe the holocaust he can see, and Ilario Dionisi on the Union bike GI Motorsports MB Agusta, they've all survived intact, no broken bones. They may even be out for the rerun of the race, which will take place at about 2:50.
He only knows as they go down through the chicane. He only knows he will overtake him, and there is nothing, absolutely nothing, that Lorenzo can do. Because that front tyre there as well for Jorge Lorenzo, that's the hard mixing option rear tyre. He just hasn't been comfortable all the time. What about that? Oh, you know, he's totally gone. Yannone rides the back of Lorenzo. Yannone got it way, way too hot. Down at turn number 10. It's been made wide open into turn 10. Way, way too hot. I'm afraid Andrea Yannone has got to take full responsibility for that. He was coming from just way, way too back. Look at this. He's going to torpedo Jorge Lorenzo. That is almost a carbon copy of the last corner when he took out Andrea Dovizioso in Argentina.